What is up, guys? Welcome back to a new video. Today I'm going to show you how to blur an area with DaVinci Resolve 16. I recently made the switch from Adobe Premiere to DaVinci Resolve 16 for my video editing workflow. And why I did this is the topic of another video that will come in the future. But because video editing is part of my daily routine or my daily workflow, I thought why not create a few videos around that, especially because the tutorials existing for DaVinci Resolve 16 are still very few, and especially this topic, I was not able to find a solution to that, so I thought why not create a video, it might help somebody else as well. Alright, let's get right into it. So in many of my videos I need to blur certain stuff out, like MAC addresses of devices or SSIDs of Wi-Fi networks and stuff like this. And I had a solution previously on DaVinci Resolve 15, which was through the color module here, and I won't show you how to do that now because it's quite cumbersome, so I actually didn't use it at all. I was still using Premiere at the time because it was much easier there. But gladly I found a feature where I could do that via diffusion module and using an adjustment clip. And I'm not sure they introduced it with DaVinci Resolve 16 or it was already existing in 15 and I just didn't know about it. But this is a really easy way on how to blur stuff out. And I'll show you an example right now. I already have an adjustment clip here where I blurred out the MAC address of this Unify access point. And we're gonna do the same thing for an example part of this clip here, and we try to blur out this not available field here using this adjustment clip. Alright, so make sure, first of all, you're on the edit tab, then you go on the left side to the effects panel, and you're gonna go to adjustment clip and you just drag it onto your timeline, and then you click on the adjustment clip, or you can do that in the next window. You go over to Fusion. And what you want to do then, you want to make sure you have the correct adjustment clip selected here. And you can easily find that out if you have multiple adjustment clips, because this is the order of your timeline. And the already existing adjustment clip was further ahead in the timeline, so it's obviously this one. And if you click on it, you can already see that there are some edits on this one. All right, so let's go ahead and edit this adjustment clip. As I said, make sure you have the adjustment clip selected and then click on the blur module or blur icon here, and then you will see that it adds a blur effect on to your adjustment clip. And it's important that you first use the blur effect and then you click on the rectangle here, because what it does then is it connects the rectangle to the blur effect, and you can see a big rectangle appearing up here. I'm gonna make this a little bit bigger so you can see it better. And then you can go ahead and drag this however you want to have it. You can even do different things with it, different sizes. And we wanted to blur out this not available thing here. All right, we make it really nice and fitting, small as we want to. And you can even make this smaller and blur out smaller stuff. You can zoom into the window and adjust this. And then you need to go back to the blur effect. And you need to adjust the blur size as much as you want, or up until a point where it's not readable anymore. And you can see this is really easy and it's blurred out already. Then we go back to the edit tab. And once we are back in the edit tab, we want to make sure that this adjustment clip here is ranging over the whole distance of the clip we want to blur. So as we can see here, it starts the clip and it's already blurred, and it will go throughout the whole area or the whole distance of this adjustment clip. So you can see this is a really easy way on how to blur an area with DaVinci Resolve 16. It's a quick solution, and that's it for this video. If it was helpful, guys, please give it a thumbs up. You know what to do. Also subscribe to the channel. And if you'd like to see more content around DaVinci Resolve 16, if you enjoy that content, please let me know in the comments below, because I'm still learning DaVinci Resolve 16. It's a great software. I really like it, especially for new creators who don't have the money to spend on something like Premiere. It's completely free. You can go ahead, download it and get started right away. And it's a really powerful tool, especially if you do stuff like color grading. It's really amazing. And I highly recommend using it and learning it. So if you want to see more content around that, especially if you run a tech channel too and want to learn stuff like this, what I use in my daily workflow, leave a comment below. I'll be happy to provide the content. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Bye.